So we're just going to put a bass part down now. So to do this, I've just got a bass guitar and I'm plugging it straight into my audio interface, just with a standard guitar jack. Depending on what audio interface you have, some of them may have an instrument input. If you have an instrument input, then just plug straight into that. Other interfaces have a combination mic line input, the jack as part of a XLR connector. So you can just put it into that, and then you just need to set up your audio interface so that it's looking at the instrument input. So in Pro Tools, we just go track new, and then we need to give that track a name. So it's always good to give tracks a name before you record, because then your audio files will be named according to what the content is. We then need to flick over to the mix window and we need to set the input. And in this case, I have plugged the bass into audio input 2 on my recording interface. So once we've done that, we can record enable the track, and then we can check our signal level and we can set our signal level so that it's looking good at the input. And we would do that from the audio interface. We can't do that from within Pro Tools. We then go and we turn low latency monitoring on. And as we know, what that does is it actually cuts the return from Pro Tools into my headphones from the bass where there's some latency added. If we set low latency monitoring on, then the bass guitar that I'm hearing in my headphones is just coming from the loop through my interface. And then after you do that, you want to have a play through the track to have a sound check, because you want to get your headphone mix sounding right. And using this method, you just leave your bass level where it is in your headphones, and then you change your Pro Tools faders and play around with those until you've balanced the backing tracks up against the bass in your headphones. So then we'll go and record a take. So to do that, we do need a click track reference. So I've got a click track in the session, and I've also got the metronome button turned on in the transport bar. I have a 2-bar count off set, which you can see here. And so I can just go into record play, and then it will play through the count off. Then it will drop me into record.